Well, for me, it's really important that my work have impact, not only in the scientific community, but in the pesticide regulatory community and in the farming community in general.
I work for the European Commission, and I believe that my work should be made available to the public. This is why open access is my default option for publications.
Well, I choose to publish high-quality works, both OA and non-OA. So, for example, my Nature Communication papers, they may get cited, you know, in a year, within a year, maybe around 100 citations.
Dogs are all owned by humans. Humans need to know what's happening with their dogs and their health. So open access publication means we can reach everyone in the world with our research.
Well, over the years, I've published increasingly in open access journals, and in consequence, the number of readers and citations and downloads and social media impact has increased. And I doubt very much that would have happened if I hadn't published open access.
Well, the impact of an open access publication is considerably different than a normal one. For instance, after I published in Nature Food this year, I've been invited to several conferences and workshops as a plenary speaker. This has made my work much more interesting.
I was hoping that the PMRA, which is the pesticide regulatory body in my country, would read the article and then would make good decisions about pesticide use. That is exactly what happened. They removed soil application of neonicotinoids to crops as a use option in Canada. And that has really had protective value for ground nesting bees. I would say do it. That is the best way to have impact. Unfortunately, there is a high cost associated with open access publishing, so make sure you actually write funding for that into any grants that you write. There's really no point in publishing if people can't access the work you do.
What I was hoping to achieve from open access publication was sharing good evidence with the wider world. That includes owners and academics and welfare scientists. What we have achieved is gradual and progressive shifting in how people perceive the innate health of dogs. As somebody that's published over 100 open access papers, a question I would actually pose to anyone who isn't doing it is why not? It is by far and away the most effective way for science to change the world that we live in. Dissemination is king.